Good morning, students. Today we are going to see with lesson 2, scalar and vector. I think you already know with this terms scalar and vector. So what is this scalar and vector is? Scalar, it is a property which is described only by its magnitude. So if you are seeing only with the magnitude, that denotes your scalar. Okay, so scalar is a property which denotes only a magnitude. But vector is a property which describes both magnitude and direction. So whatever quantities we are taking, if we take both with the magnitude and direction, that is said to be vector. Okay, only magnitude, that is scalar, magnitude and direction, that is vector. So examples for scalar is distance, mass, speed and temperature. Okay, distance, mass, speed and temperature. For vectors, it is velocity, force and displacement. Yes, so this is about scalar and vector. Scalar and vector can be asked even in 3 marks. What is the difference between scalar and vector? So you have to write this. Yes, then the next one is types of vectors. We have various types of vectors. What are they? Are the first one is equal vectors, next one is collinear vectors, next unit vectors and orthogonal unit vectors. So for considering with these types of vectors, we are going to consider 2 vectors, namely A and B. So those vectors A and B, how they are? If they are equal, means equal in magnitude as well as in direction, collinear. So all this, we'll just see this one by one. First one is equal vectors. So see here, we are having with a 2 vectors which are named as A and B. So if these 2 vectors have equal magnitude and also same direction. So what is meant by magnitude is value. So when you see here, if this value is 5 and same way this value is also 5, so I can say that it is having same magnitude. So from here to this point, it is having the same magnitude, okay, and also same direction. So it is pointing along the same direction. If it is so, then they are said to be equal vectors. Then next one is collinear vectors. So what are collinear vectors? Is the collinear vectors are those which act along the same line. So if the lines are same, then they are said to be the collinear vectors. In collinear vectors, the angle is either 0 or 180. If the angle made is 0 or 180, that are said to be collinear vectors. So see here, this is A and this is B. So these both are in the acting along the same line, so that the angle is, so angle made here is 180. Same way, angle made here is 180. Okay. Among this collinear vector, we have the types, parallel as well as anti-parallel. So what is meant by parallel is they act in the same direction or the parallel lines, so that the angle is angle made between them. So see here, between them is between these two, the angle made is 0 because they are acting in the same direction. So same direction means you will be drawing one over the other, so one over the other like this, so that the angle made here is 0. So if the angle made is 0 degree, then that are said to be the parallel vectors. Yes, so collinear, we have 2 types, parallel as well as the anti-parallel. Next one is the anti-parallel vectors. So see here, this is the anti-parallel vectors. In this anti-parallel vectors, we have the 2 vectors which are acting in a different direction. So if it is acting in a different direction, you can just draw like this, one vector and the second vector, so that the angle made between them is what? 180 degree. So if the angle made is 180 degree, that is called as anti-parallel vectors. The angle made is 0 degree, that are called as a parallel vectors. Okay, next is unit vectors. So what is a unit vector? Is the term itself defines, it is unit, which means the value is equal to 1. If the value is equal to 1, then that are said to be the unit vectors. See here, the vector which is divided by its magnitude is a unit vector. So if you are denoting a vector as A vector, then the unit vector is denoted by the letter A cap. So this is said to be cap. Okay, so if we are writing this A and this is cap, that denotes the unit vectors. Okay, so this A cap, which is equal to A vector divided by A, which denotes the modulus of A, which is also said to be the value of A. Okay, now from this we can also write, if you want A vector, this if you are bringing to other side, you'll get A into A cap. So this is a unit vector. Unit vector is nothing but the value which will be equal to 1. Next is orthogonal unit vector. So what is the orthogonal unit vector is, we are considering the vectors in the x, y and z coordinates. So this is x, y and z coordinates, and such that the angle between all this is 90 degrees. So see here, here as well as in this. So all these angles are what? They are equal to 90 degree. If the angles are equal to 90 degree, that vectors are said to be the orthogonal unit vectors. So orthogonal unit vectors are nothing but their angle is equal to 90 degree. We are considering three vectors along the three coordinates x, y and z. Next we are going to see is about addition of vectors. So when you are considering the two vectors, and if you have to find the addition, we are using with triangle of addition. For this triangle of addition, let us represent the two vectors A and B as the adjacent sides of a triangle. So when you are considering a triangle, so if this is a triangle and these are the two adjacent sides of a triangle, then the resultant is the third side of the triangle. So this is a resultant, and that resultant is the third side of the triangle. So this is R. If you are taking with two vectors that are represented as A and B, so let us consider two vectors A and B. If A and B represent two adjacent sides of the triangle, then the resultant is third side of the triangle. So this is a diagram for the magnitude of the resultant of the vectors when you are considering the triangle addition. So as I told you, we are considering the two vectors A and B, and this gives your resultant. So resultant is denoted by the closing side of the triangle. Okay, next is, let us consider the triangle. So this small triangle you are going to consider, we are just going to take that to be a right angle triangle. So if you are taking a right angle triangle, let us take this triangle. Now we are going to mark the parts here. Let us consider this point to be C and this one to be A, and here let us consider as B. This is a diagram here, but in your reader, in this, in your book, instead of C, we'll be writing with the term N. Okay, so here let us take the term to be N. This is N. And here is A, and here we have the term B. And let us take the angle here. The angle which you are going to measure here is theta, that is near the term A. So here we are going to measure the angle to be theta. Yes, now this is what? This is a right angle triangle. So considering the right angle triangle, you can find the value of sine and cos. Is it not? What is the formula for sine theta? It is opposite divided by hypotenuse. So the opposite side here is this one. So BN divided by the hypotenuse. The hypotenuse, we are representing this value to be B. So why you are writing as B is because, as we know, we are considering with the two vectors, which is A, and here is the vector B. So opposite is BN divided by B. Okay. Now when you have to find the value of bn alone, this you are going to bring it to other side. So this becomes as b into sin theta. Same way, from this same triangle, if you are going to find the value of cos, so cos, it is adjacent by hypotenuse. So adjacent side here is an, divided by hypotenuse is again b. So it is, so we get the value of an is equal to b into cos theta, because we are taking b this side, and so we get an is equal to b into cos theta. Yes. So next is, we are going to, here we took only with this small triangle, which is this A, B and C. This is a small triangle which you took. Now you are going to take with this full big triangle. Using that, you are going to find the value. Yes. For finding that, let us consider the triangle which is represented by O, B and N. So considering this triangle, this is actually a right angle triangle. So first, when you are considering with a right angle triangle, here this is O, this is N and this is B. So considering with a right angle triangle O, B and N, first when you apply with Pythagoras theorem, the Pythagoras theorem is the longest side is equal to the sum of other two sides. So which is the longest side here is hypotenuse. So this is the longest side OB, that is equal to the other two, which is opposite, and this side is adjacent, because here we have the angle theta. So the opposite to this angle is BN. The next side is the adjacent side, which is ON. And so we have the hypotenuse square, which is OB square, which is equal to ON square plus BN square. Now see this value of ON. In middle you have the term A, is it not? And so this full term, this is a full one, so this is represented as O, and this we are writing as N, and in the middle you have with A. So this full ON can be written as OA plus AN. So this is OA and this is AN, and so this full ON can be written as OA plus AN. So I am writing here as OA, this ON square, instead of that I am writing as OA plus AN the whole square. We should not write as OA square plus AN square, because this we are writing this value plus this, so this is whole square. So now substitute the values here. Instead of this OA, this can be written as A, and so I am writing here as A. Next is AN. AN, that is equal to what? B into cos theta. And so I am writing here as B into cos theta. Yes. Then BN. So BN value is what? That is B into sin theta. And so I am writing here as B into sin theta. Now expand this. So when you see here, this is of the form A square A plus B the whole square, is it not? So this is A plus B. Instead of B, we have the term B cos theta the whole square. So when you expand, you will get as A square plus B square. So instead of B square, I am writing here as B square cos square theta. So this fully I am squaring. So B square cos square theta plus 2A into B. So 2 into A B into cos theta. Okay, so this I am just expanding as A square plus B square plus 2AB. Okay, then this term just squaring here, so you will get B square into sin square theta as it is. This question is very very important. So till this, I will say once again, first for this step we are taking the Pythagoras theorem. So Pythagoras theorem, which is longest side square is equal to sum of other two sides. So longest side is OB square is equal to ON square plus BN. Instead of ON, this full term we are writing as OA plus AN. And so I am writing here as OA plus AN the whole square plus BN square. Now expand, now write the values of OA and AN here. Now expand this using A plus B the whole square, and this I am expanding as it is. Okay. Then next is, from these two terms, we have b square cos square theta and b square sin square theta. So from these two terms, I'm going to take b square common. So if I'm taking b square common here, the remaining here is cos square theta, and this side we have sin square theta. So that can be written as b square into cos square plus sin square theta. So only I'm taking with these two terms, this and this. The remaining terms I'm writing as it is. Now cos square theta plus sin square theta, the value is 1. And so we get a square plus b square plus this becomes 1. And so here we have 2ab into cos theta. This is the value of OB square. So OB here, it represents R. And so we are writing as R square. So this is the value of R square. But next is, if you have to find the value of R, so this square goes to the other side, that becomes as root. And so we are getting R is equal to root of a square plus b square plus 2ab into cos theta. Okay, so this is very, very, very important derivation, triangle of vectors. So first, before finding with all this value, first step is taking with a small triangle and finding the value of an and bn. So first itself we found out with this. Next is taking with this triangle, considering this as the hypotenuse, because there is a hypotenuse. Next, using Pythagoras theorem, we are writing this square is equal to sum of the other two sides. Then instead of on, we'll be writing as oa plus an. Now write the values, expand this, taking this b square common outside, this becomes as 1. Then square comes this side, that becomes as root. Yes, so this gives your magnitude. So next is, we have to find the direction. For finding with the direction, let us consider this same triangle. From this same triangle, if you have to find the value of tan, so what is the value of tan? Is tan is equal to opposite divided by adjacent. So opposite side here is bn, so opposite is bn divided by the adjacent. So adjacent side here is on. Again, we know that on can be written as sum of this two. So this can be written as oa plus an. Next is, instead of oa, we'll be writing as a. Then on can be written as b cos theta. Then instead of bn, we'll be writing as b sin theta. Yes, so that is what is given in the next step for finding the value of tan. Because tan is equal to what? Tan is equal to opposite divided by adjacent. So opposite side we are writing as bn divided by adjacent can be written as on. Now again, instead of this on, I'm writing as oa plus an. Okay, so we'll write that to be tan alpha, which is equal to opposite by adjacent. So opposite side here is bn divided by on. On I'm writing as oa plus an. Then next is bn can be written as b sin theta. Oa is equal to a. Then an is equal to b into cos theta. Write it as it is. Here we have the term tan alpha. If you have to find only the value of alpha, this tan, if you are going to bring it to other side, that becomes as tan inverse. Okay, so tan, if you are going to bring it to other side, that becomes as tan inverse. So we are getting as tan inverse of b sin theta divided by a plus b into cos theta. So this gives your direction of the resultant of two vectors. Okay, so we have found out the value of r. The r gives your magnitude, and next is alpha. The alpha gives your direction of resultant of two vectors. So this is about the triangle of vectors. Okay, thank you.